That's better. You ain't heard nothing. You want to hear Toot Toot Tootsie? All right. Hold on. Hold on.
Play Toot Toot Tootsie. Three choruses, you understand? And the third chorus, I whistle. Now give it to him hard and heavy. Go right ahead.
The Rialto is a product of the jazz age in South Pasadena. People were going nuts building theaters. There were thousands built. It was built by a local banker named Clyde Church, who had some land, and a promoter, C.L. Langley. And it was part of the vaudeville circuit, so it was built as both a movie theater and live theater experience.
Mr. Olson, would you play something for Eddie? Do that, will you?
Sound came to film in 1928, and the Rialto got its sound system in 1929, and nobody knew whether it was going to be the Vitaphone or the competing movie tone system that was going to prevail, so they installed both. And so one of them used sound on a record player, and the other used optical sound on film. And for a while, you could see all kinds of movies there either way.
This organ was built for the Rialto Movie Theater. It opened in October 17, 1925. Vaudeville came in, and of course it was the perfect instrument for that.
Played for the silent movies for two or three years.
And this rose up out of the floor, and everybody applauded when it would come up.
This was one of the best organs of its time. There were only 12 or 13 of these things made. It saw its heyday in 1966, when fame theater organist George Wright recorded live there. The organ was used both in the live theater and the vaudeville show, and then it was also used to augment the silent films, which were played, you know, throughout the 20s and 30s. Now, one of the things that makes the theater so appealing is that it's got a 35-foot fly space. Now, that means that there's panels that can drop down and be used, and there's ropes and curtains and things like this.
They can attach scenery and stuff, and they can run them right up into the ceiling, make them disappear. And
this sounds like a wonderful thing because it could be used as a legitimate theater in addition to a movie theater. In the 1970s, somebody thought it would be a good idea to tear it down. And in fact, if you've looked at the history of that, it went all the way to City Council and got approval. And because of a local community effort to save the theater, the Rialto was given at that time a landmark status.
The property is actually designated as a national, state, and local historic site.
And saved, if you will, from the wrecking ball. So we have those people to thank that it's not a parking lot today.
However, it doesn't mean that it can sit for a long period of time to a point where you have no choice but to demolish the building. Well, it's private property. Keep in mind that it would take tens of millions of dollars to bring the Rialto back up to a decent shape. The city's general fund is $21 million, and so we wouldn't be able to dedicate significant funding that would require the Rialto to bring back to a decent state.
That theater is owned by a family trust, and it's leased under the terms of a 99-year lease by a theater operating company. Mr. Jebbia, Dominic Jebbia, who bought the Rialto Theater in the 1930s with cash, then in the 1950s put it in a trust. He's long since deceased, and his family that he deeded it to passed it on to their children. And now these are the people who are technically the owners of the Rialto. Unfortunately, they can't really do too much with it because they've got this 99-year lease that's attached to it.
I think we can all agree that the Rialto has taken a turn for the worse. Old, the facade and the plaster is a safety issue, and there's also a lot of fire safety issues as well.
The theater is languishing, and everybody wants to bring it back to life. Nobody knows how. So until somebody, either the city or an investor, buys that lease and buys that building, nobody's going to be able to do anything with that property.
The chamber produced a white paper, Vision Rialto. And that explored many ways that the Rialto Theater can come back.
What we said in our Vision Rialto report was that you have to have a story about what's going on inside that theater. Is it a cinema pub? Is it a legitimate theater? Is it a multi-use performing arts facility?
The Rialto Theater is a single screen theater. It's not a very strong model in today's economy. Most theaters are multi-screen. And so in order for the Rialto to come back, we would have to look really hard at a single screen model and something that the community can support.
Anybody who's looking into the Rialto and trying to understand its history has to see that entertainment and theater going was changing all this time. It used to be a big deal to get dressed up and go out to the movies. The argument for the Rialto or against the Rialto has always been parking, parking, parking.
It doesn't have dedicated parking. The big building that sits at the corner of Fair Oaks and Oxley has no dedicated parking. And so if the building was to come back in a different kind of use, it would have to adhere to current parking standards.
It is possible to use existing shared parking agreements and make it come alive. It's more desirable to have it be a part of a parking plan with a developed downtown district that has a parking garage. And in fact, there is such a plan in the works called Downtown South Pass. There's a commission called the Community Redevelopment Commission, and they have a completely approved plan that has retail, housing, and 435 parking spaces that could easily be used in a shared agreement with the Rialto. And all they need is a developer and some money.
The proposed downtown project is estimated to provide an additional 400 spaces for the downtown area. When banks are closed at 5 p.m., the Rialto, should it be open, can then have access to the parking spaces through an agreement between the Rialto and the future downtown project developer. We are currently in negotiations, actually just signed an exclusive negotiation agreement with the developer that has the funding to move this project forward. The bottom line would be is a synergy approach to have different types of businesses so that the Rialto, which sits right adjacent to this proposed project, would be able to thrive in an environment where it is pedestrian friendly and business friendly. I don't think there is anyone who would want to see the Rialto be demolished. I think we all agree that something needs to be done.
We would really like to see it become a center for the arts and something that South Pasadena and the broader San Gabriel Valley could enjoy.
It's a very rich cultural landmark in the city of South Pass, and the question will be, how does it come back when it comes back? And we're all hoping it does.